Okay, we're looking at a video on the internal division of a line into a given ratio. So we've got 2 points, a point here and a point here, and we want to divide that interval, that line, into a ratio of m to n by this point here and trying to find it. So in this video, I've just got the formula, and on the last page is an example. And then in between, I've got the full proof, which you don't have to worry about learning off by heart. So here's the formula. So the first point is x1, y1. The second point is x2, y2. The ratio is m to n, or m over n. And this point that we're trying to find is given by this formula. So you'll notice it's like a crossover formula. M is going to be multiplied by x2, and n multiplied by x1 over n plus n, and m multiplied by y2 plus n times y1 over n plus n. So that's the formula that we're going to use, and I'm going to show you the proof that you don't have to know, but I'm just going to show you where it comes from. I say copy that and come across. So what we've got, instead of having x1, I'm just going to use this hk, because I'm using these x1, y1s, and x2, y2s, and it gets a little bit confusing. And what I've got is some distances over here, and we're going to use similar triangles. Okay, so this is all going to be done with similar triangles, which you've done in year 9 and 10, and maybe year 8. So AQ is the distance along the bottom, so it's the difference between the X's. AP is the difference between the AP is the difference, so that's so that should be H minus X1. Okay, so difference of x and x1. AB is going along the line, so that's m, and AC is m plus n, because that was m and that was n. BP is coming down here, so there's a difference in the y, so it's k minus y1, and CQ is a difference in the y, is y2 minus y1. So those distances come from that triangle. Now, in terms of the similar triangles, so short triangle AB over big triangle AC must be the same as AP over AQ. And from here, up the top there, we've got AB M over M plus N equals H minus X1 over X2 minus X1. So then I flip both fractions upside down. So I turn the fractions upside down. I don't need to do that. So I just need to cross multiply. Okay, so the X2 minus X1 comes across to the M. And then I'm going to take the x1 across by adding. And then because these have denominators, so I need to make a common denominator of m plus n. So this number here is just multiplied by x1 plus what already is up on the top, and then it's all over m plus n. Then I expand the brackets, m times x1, n times x1. And then you'll notice that mx1 and mx1 cancel out. And then I just bring this to the front, mx2 plus mx1 over n plus n. Okay, so that's the h value, which is going to be the x value of the point that we're trying to find. Okay, then AB over AC equals, so small over big equals small over big, so it's the same sort of setup for similar triangles, and then you get the same sort of relationship, and then you cross multiply, and then you add the y1, so I get the same sort of approach as I had over here, and then etc. etc. You cross multiply, expand out, and you end up with this answer here. So the formula from the first page had been proved by similar triangles. Okay. All right. So let's look at an example. You don't need to worry about copying that down. Okay. So divide the line joining 8, 9 and minus 7, 4 into the ratio 2 to 3. Now this diagram is not to scale, but what we're trying to find is some point where that distance there is 2 and that distance there is 3 into comparison to each other. Okay, they're not 2s and 3s, it's just the ratio. Okay, so what I've done is I've written x1 is 8, x2 is minus 7, y1 is 9, y2 is 4, n is n, n is 3. And so in the formula, it's going to be m times x2 plus n times x1 over m plus n. So that's just 2 plus 3 is 5. And then you cancel down and you get 2. And similarly, m is multiplied by y2 plus n is multiplied by y1 over n plus n, so you get that answer. So the point we're trying to find is 2, 7. So my diagram's not drawn to scale, like it's over that side of the line, but I wasn't drawing it, so that was not to scale. Okay, so that's the internal division. So it's just an application of a formula. There's obviously applications of it which you'll find in exercises that you're going to have to do. Okay, thanks, bye.